We have $50 from RH Stormy. Haven't been able to watch nearly as much because I just finished a movie now today. Luckily, the best chunks of games are from now on. We have $10 from Slow Beef. Thanks for running one of my favorite games. Good luck on Hell Run. $50 from Michael R. Keep up all the good work. We have $30 from Keza. Keep up the good work. Love from Finland. $50 from One Wing Day. I was going to put this towards LM 100% race, but we hit that while I was sleeping. So instead, let's go for the pajama percent because sleep. We have $10 from Femoral. My third donation this year, one of my best friends, Mini Matt, introduced me to Cave Story a few years ago, and it changed my life. This donation is for him. Put towards Chrono Trigger 100%. We have $30 from Merkfett. Need more team poor life choices. We have $50 from Paper Crane. Cave Story is great, but let's see Chrono Trigger 100%. We have $100 from Simon Vicklund. High fives to everyone making this awesome event possible, and everyone tuning in and donating. Here's 100 Buckazoids for you guys to tune up the music while you rush BCR2. Good luck with the game and the rest of the marathon.
And welcome everyone back to Summer Games Done Quick 2015. I'm your host, Spike the Cheetah, and it is time for one of those runs. It's a PJ run. Summer Games Done Quick 2015 is brought to you by The Yeti, Tiny Build, The Mega Man Legacy Collection, World 9 Gaming, SomethingArtistic.net, Power Up Audio, Alienware, and The Humble Bundle. I've got $75 from Yagamoth. The more I watch about Cave's story, the more I'm considering picking it up as a speedrun myself. Thank you for all your runs. Also, PJ and hype mode must be met. And to clarify, hype mode, in fact, has been met. There's going to be a little extra stipulation to it. So we'll let PJ get a little ways into the run before we start that, though. So are we going to add another thing that's...
We're here and we're ready to start. That's not the same as good.
Yeah. You're good back there? Yep.
All right.
All right, sweet. I'm going to give a countdown even though I'm in control of the timer. 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so this is Bionic Commando Rearmed 2. I'm going to start with a quick roll call before we forget. I'm PJ. I'm the one running this.
I'm Murphigator. I am the one who is responsible for the Terminator being console used here.
Yeah.
I'm Satoru. I am not a member of Team Poor Life Choices. I just happen to know about this game.
I'm Clage. I'm here to keep these guys in line. It doesn't work very well.
And that's Mecha Richter off to the side. He does not have a mic because we don't want to hear anything he has to say.
Correct.
Nice. Way to go, guys.
Yep.
We did it. All right, so since the 100% category has been met, I will be doing it, obviously. 100% in this game means I'm going to be collecting everything at every level. Should be a pretty standard thing by now. At the end of each stage, it tells you what items you collected, and basically I need to collect all of those. That's what I use as a definition. I do not require the max speed rank on these levels because there are a few auto-scrollers that you actually cannot get speed rank on if you get 100%. Just because, like, literally the entire stage is an auto-scroller, so the game expects you to just go in the door afterwards. This first stage is a bit frantic because there are a lot of things that happen here. So there's the first one. And
nice job.
This is the second glitch, and this is something that that Greenalink found. That should be it. I take this bazooka. So you're not supposed to be able to grab that, but what he found is that if you are facing the opposite direction from where you shot the grapple, the game kind of just ignores your collision detection. So I'm able to fire the grapple, then turn around, and then reactivate collision detection. All right, so this is, I need serious time here. Oh, come on, Spencer. There we go. So this is what we call hype mode.
You donated for this.
Spencer literally cannot stop screaming. He is so excited to be here. Now, Spike Vegeta will go ahead and explain how this is going to work for this round.
So, yes, you all did donate for this, and we thank you for all your generosity. However, there might be some of you who, this run is an hour and 40 minutes, so maybe you don't want to listen to it the whole time. But maybe some of you are just that hype here at 9 o'clock at Summer Games Done Quick 2015. If you want to, and you should, get in on this new insane bid war, can you handle the hype? Go to the Games Done Quick website, go to our bidding war page, and you can check out, it's a bid war between silence and hype. We'll be checking that throughout the run. Whichever one is in the lead, obviously PJ can turn it on and off basically at will in this game. Yeah. So get in your donations and let's have some fun.
All right, so that was another pull items through wall trick. Really, when you play through this stage the first time, you're only supposed to be able to get the grenade and the health upgrade. But I just grab everything because I don't want to do revisits. So, yeah, we grabbed pretty much all four items that we're going to use in the game in the very first stage. We grabbed the grenade, which is pretty great. It breaks all blocks. We got the bazooka, which you're not supposed to have until stage 16. So we got that a bit early, and as you could maybe see in that boss fight, the game is not prepared for you to have that early.
No.
So I can break any piece of terrain in the game now, including non-breakable things, because I can go through them.
So you sure Spencer's not just hyped because after 25 years he finally learned how to jump?
I think it's because of his mustache. Oh, come on. Really? There we are.
We don't actually need that elevator, just...
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, no, he's just so excited that he doesn't have to ride down it. He's been to this hotel before. He knows how long the wait is. He's just loving it, man.
To note, hype's in the lead.
Oh, good. So. Good. Yes. I'd say this gets old, but it really,
no.
Really doesn't.
Nope,
it doesn't even get close to old.
So this is a really cool stage. I honestly love the level design in this game. Like, the levels are really, really cool. This game gets a lot of bad reviews, but I legitimately, unironically love this game.
So does Spencer.
So does Spencer, man. He could not be happier. So if you play this game, or this stage in any percent, you just have to, like, you can skip all these doors. Basically, all of this is optional, and you can just run to the right straight to the exit. But in 100%, I get to go through all these, like, boot camp rooms. I don't know if that's supposed to teach you, like, the intricacies of the grapple or whatnot, but I just go through the floor, grab the item, and leave. Coming up is the most difficult clip in the entire game, which is nice to have at the very beginning. So what I have to do is I use this bucket to pull myself through the floor again. So that's the first half. Now I have to get back inbounds, and it's significantly easier to get out of bounds than it is to get inbounds. And I have to do this completely blind because, well, there's a mountain here. So, he's trying his hardest, you can hear.
He's trying to use sonar.
Hey, it worked! You gave him the idea. He's like, oh, wait, I could just do that, couldn't I? That's also a scary part because if I don't succeed in killing myself, which it's a lot harder than it sounds sometimes. Sometimes the bazooka just does no damage. Then I'm just stuck in that room, and I have to redo the whole stage. So, yeah, that was good. That was, like, a lot of tries, but I actually got it and didn't die, so I'm pretty happy about that. And that, again, as you imagine, saves a revisit. That is certainly not the way you're supposed to get that power up. You're supposed to get this hacking claw, and then you hack into the computer and it opens up a gate. But I use the back door. I cannot activate hype mode in this stage, so you're going to have to make your intentions clear in the next two stages. And you're going to be committed to that, because the fifth stage is an auto-scroller. So, yeah, just keep that in mind. The Mighty Jungle is a stage, again, that I really like. The level design in here is pretty cool. This is one of three stages where I actually have to revisit them. I cannot get all the items on the first visit, and that makes me sad. But what are you gonna do? I'm like one clip away from skipping all the revisits in the game, but it's too robust for me so far.
Yeah, those walls have proved to be very challenging.
Yeah.
Yeah, the main reason it's so challenging for him to route out all of them is because water in this game actually kills you instantly, and the last item that he needs is pretty much right along a water plane.
Yeah.
And so the options for getting out of bounds and grabbing stuff is very limited.
Yeah, and the out-of-bounds terrain there is really, really elaborate. Like, in most places, it's just like, all right, there's like a one-tile-thick ceiling. That's what the scream attack is supposed to do, by the way. I guess I should explain how that works at some point. Hype mode... Well, that attack is called Death from Above, and that's something he learned in 2K9, right?
Yeah.
Right, Murph? Yeah? Okay. So yeah, you just do like this ground pound thing and it crushes enemies that are below you. But if you interrupt it before it gets to land, Spencer just doesn't stop screaming. Okay. So the item I need is right underneath me, but I can't get... Oh, there's an elevator here. I actually could have.
At the very end of the stage.
Oh, right. Right, at the very end of the stage. Haha. Come on, you. Now, if you listen closely, he's really angry that I didn't get this item the first time.
I forgot something!
The tone of hype mode changes drastically depending on how we feel about the stages.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've got a $50 donation from Nymphs. Yeah!
Oh, yeah, you're going to have a good time during this run, Spike.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure all of the donations are just going to be screaming.
Or for the love of God, please stop the screaming.
Yeah.
They said they wanted someone very experienced for PJ's run.
Yeah.
I wonder why.
All we really meant was that he had good enough vocal cords to keep screaming.
Yeah. Yeah. Also, so that when you quit, we can get some fresh blood in, so it's not just all the same folks. All right, so I grabbed another weapon here. This game is really phenomenal at weapon balance, and I'm not being ironic. Like, the weapons in this game are really, really good, and all of them serve a unique purpose. This is the Goliath launcher, which, by the sound of it, you would think is the bazooka weapon, but it's not, because I already have the bazooka. The Goliath launcher is like this boomerang launcher thing, which is a really neat concept, and it changes with your height. So you can shoot it and jump and get it to weave around stuff. Usually I just fire it directly into enemies' faces, because it's strong. But sometimes I can fire it around barrels and save myself some trouble that way. These things that I'm collecting, those are called the Yashichis. It's like a Capcom staple. It's in a bunch of their games ever since like the arcade era. They do absolutely nothing in this game. In BCR1, they unlock something that does absolutely nothing, but at least you get to collect something else. In this game, they literally just don't do anything. But it's shown in the score tally thing, so I grab it. Nice. Goliath launcher.
Yeah, it's pretty fair.
A reminder, that elevator down there is the item that I cannot get yet. I have to revisit this stage later, so we will get to see that. That was a good stage, actually. Yeah. All right, what's the verdict? Is hype mode still winning?
Yeah.
It won't be.
You mean, yeah? The update is we have $602 for hype.
Gosh.
We have a penny for science.
We may have misjudged this bid war.
Yeah. Yep. A penny. Wow. All right. Well.
Literally say kill the animals.
Now, we have a helicopter, but Spencer is not stopping. So these enemies get to see a screaming, crazy Spencer shoot them out of the shot. Like, man, look out for that guy. He's pointing the gun at his own helicopter. Everything's going to be okay, Clage.
Nope. Not a chance.
He's as good as dead.
Yeah. This guy heard. He's like, wait, maybe if I crouch. Maybe, no, maybe. No. What?
How much? What?
I'll get him.
What are these soldiers made of?
Don't worry about them. I'm actually kind of worried about who stationed them here. Because all of them are just, like, facing the wall with their guns out. This guy's just looking at the bucket. Hey, bucket. You stay right there.
I've got a $5 donation from Goku235. Kamehameha! And then he says, Spencer can finish the rest.
He sure can. Oh, man. So, yeah, this helicopter, this is a new thing in the Bionic Commando series. This game has a few cool things in it. There are also sniper towers in some stages. There's a sniper tower in the Mighty Jungle. And there's one later in one of the bridge levels. The sniper towers are not required, but if you go in them, you get like the crosshairs like this. And you just get to shoot enemies, and they don't get to dodge. You just free headshots. So it's kind of cool to do, and it's a neat feature, and I'm glad it's not forced. Helicopters are forced, but they're still pretty fun the first time. If you do it a few hundred times, it's not. Unless you're Spencer. So I shut it off early there because I'm going to kill myself here. I got the hacking arm right there. That's what I needed in stage 2 to get the item that I already got.
I've got $200 from Crumsley. Don't stop the hype.
All right.
We've also got $50 from our own Robo Sparkle. Spencer sounds amazing, but I'm still waiting for him to say Oklahoma and finish the song. And $100 from Steven Wilson. I couldn't miss a chance to donate during another PJ run. PJ, you rule.
Thank you.
And don't fret, Spencer is silent. Just know that he's still screaming on the inside. Yeah.
So I suppose I should maybe mention that glitch, because it's not going to stop. So on these one tile high items on the ground, well, really any grappleable thing on the ground, you can kind of trick the game into letting you grab it from below, because two of Spencer's animations kind of slide into objects. And if you do a vertical grapple there, the game's just like, well, he grabbed it. I guess he's underneath it. I'm not sure how I'm going to get over this guy now. Go behind him. He's supposed to continue moving to the left, but he didn't want to. Alright. Alright, the rocket didn't kill him before. There we go. The rockets are kind of strange in this game. Sometimes they just don't hit their target. Well, in a number of ways. Right, so if you do target an enemy and you fire and the rockets hit them, sometimes they just don't do damage. But then there are other times when the rockets just refuse to hit your target and find a better one, like Spencer's own foot. And that's pretty cute. I actually hit the camera once, which was interesting. I like fell and I fired the rockets and this guy. Okay.
That barrel was a good target.
Yeah, the barrel was good. Yeah, I was falling and I fired the rocket and like the rockets kind of swarm around where they're gonna hit and they were like all over the screen. I was like, oh no, where are these gonna hit? And they like flew into the screen and like the whole screen was fire. I was like, well, okay. Gotta admire the enthusiasm. Alright, so this is our first boss. Bosses in this game could have been done a bit better.
A bit.
This boss is actually pretty tolerable. But I only say that because the others are just not good. So this is the Megacopter. You're supposed to have to grapple on like either the center or these two engines on the side. And then you shoot the engines. And once the engines are red, well, after four cycles, if the engines are red, then you get a chance to hurt them. But there's this thing over here. And I don't know if this is an intentional thing that you're supposed to be able to grab or not, but you can, so I do. And I don't have to do any dodging or anything. I can just shoot them, and then I have to wait a whole bunch. So this is the fourth cycle here. Then we climb on top of these, smash the button, and a golf cart comes out. And then we fire rockets and hope that they don't shoot the wall behind them. So this is this boss. You can go ahead and read some donations if you want.
Absolutely, and we have plenty here. I've got $50 from Final Cave is Hard, otherwise known as David Hatch. Must see Bionic PJ Hype. $20 from Lynx. This is my first time watching SGDQ, and I'm loving every moment of it. Put this towards the Chrono Trigger 100% run. $20 from T-Qualizer. There was a lack of stuff breaking during the previous runs with PJ present. Let us hope for something spectacular.
You mean Gauntlet?
Whoops. About $50 from Lorcus. I feel so hype. I'm yelling in my own house, and so should you. So I need to scroll. Okay, got it.
Well done.
About $50 from Cozart Dono. If I had $789, I would donate to remove hype. Here's 50. Gotta support the little guy. And a quick update on that bid war. We've got $1,036.06 for hype.
No! These are the worst rockets.
It's gonna be okay, PJ.
Okay, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Spike.
To note, we have $50.04 for
cents.
Silence.
Nice.
So someone else threw in three other cents. So. And $10 from Clayson 108. 108. A A A A A A A H H H H H H H H H H H.
All right. Well, unfortunately, in the next few stages, there aren't any elevators. So you're gonna get a little bit of time to make up your mind, either really, really confirm it or mount the most uphill battle ever and turn it off. Okay, good shot.
Wow.
Really well done. This stage is really, really cool. If you don't have the rocket launcher, I imagine this is an extremely difficult level. But fortunately, I have that. So that guy was just kind of playing with his drones, and I ruined all his fun. But I got some drones on my own.
Now, this isn't like the original Bionic Commando where you have to pick your weapon loadout. You just get to bring everything with you, correct?
That is correct. Yep. Yep, I've got everything with me. I don't know where he carries it, but
don't worry about
that. He's got all of it. All right, come on, Rockets. Do your thing. Nice. We actually killed him. All right, so I'm going over here first to activate a checkpoint. This is the first time we see the Crushers, but not the last. Just saves me some time from climbing back up. In the previous stages, there really wasn't any reason to do death abuse. All right, let's see if I can get this.
Nice.
That's really hard to do in real time. I did a biovision buffer when I did that in the first stage, which is basically like pause buffering, except you use this biovision scanner, which is like Metroid Prime scanner. It tells you like what enemies' weaknesses are and whatnot. There's no reason to use it in a speedrun, except for the biovision buffer if you want to. It just makes it a bit more consistent. But I don't need to do it there because the wall's thin enough.
We got $5 from Beliskner. Thanks to everyone for making SGDQ happen. Let's make Bionic Commando 100% happen. You got it.
Yeah, thank you to everybody who donated for 100%. This category is by far the more entertaining. Any percent, like you can see now, the paths branch pretty significantly. But in any percent, you wouldn't get to see any of that. You would just like run straight to the doors, and that would be the end of it. So I really enjoy 100%. I think it's really cool. I think it showcases the neat level design. And yeah. Glad you did it. There's some janky spike hitboxes here, so I hope that I can make it. Yeah, I'm good. Another suicide. This prevents me from climbing. Saves me the trouble of climbing. Might prevent me from climbing, because this game does things.
Weak.
I know. Why'd you stop? So that's a good use of the glide launcher there. You can see I was able to wrap it around that first turret and hit the one behind it. Okay. I'm not going to activate hype mode here again because I have to do death from above later. That's how you turn it off. If he actually finishes death from above, he stops screaming.
So how did you come across the out of bounds in this game, PJ?
So...
A little better.
Yeah, alright. So Murphigator had me play this last SGDQ because I played the first Rearmed, which I do not recommend anyone plays. But he wanted me to play this one. I was like, alright, fine, I'll give it a chance. That's not gonna break. And I got to the first barrel in the game. I grabbed it. I fell through the floor and drowned. And I was like, all right, game, we are going to be good friends. Yeah, it's honestly a really fun game, even without the out of bounds. Like, the grapples at first are really, really clunky because they are a lot different than the rest of the series. Like, in Bionic Commando games, once you start a swing, you can just keep holding that direction, and the grapple line will just instantly break. In this game, it will never break unless you make it break, which I guess is the rule for the whole game. Nice. So yeah, the first time you use the grapples, it's like really awkward and it doesn't make sense. But once you get used to it, you have a tremendous amount of flexibility in what you can do. Like, I don't even know what I would call a skip in this game, just because you can do so much to grab parts of terrain that are out of sequence. It's like not even worth pointing out every out-of-sequence grapple in this. But that's what makes this whole series really good. So yeah, I went out of bounds on the first barrel, and that's how I found the out-of-bounds.
Yep.
And then I found some streamlined ways of going out of bounds by accident, like jumping and then grappling up, and somehow I disappeared. Like that. It's, I did it completely by accident in one attempt, and I was like, am I gone? Like, I couldn't, you can't see anything except like the tip of the claw, and I was not expecting to be in the floor, so I was like looking in the corners of the screen, and I had no idea where I went. All right. I would fill you in on what the plot is, but I have no idea what the plot is. I did not watch a single cutscene in this game, and I haven't read the intro. I'm assuming that Spencer's just hype and angry. These guys are sunbathing, I think.
Yeah.
Or they just party real hard. Yeah, so I don't know. I think Murph knows a little bit about the plot.
I know a lot of things about the plot, and it's not it's not great, but we can explain it.
Yeah, we could do that. We got some time.
All right. So the Bionic Commando Rearmed series kind of like retcons the original Bionic Commando game slightly. So the series storyline starts with Rearmed, which is basically you going and stopping Broder and I don't remember the other villain's name, but the people they replaced Master D with because they decided they wanted to get at least slightly farther away from the obvious Nazi references. So pretty generic take on the storyline. After that, they actually made Bionic Commando 2K9, but this game comes between Bionic Commando Rearmed and 2K9 to kind of explain what happened. So in this game, you're stopping not Castro from nuking someone. And so you go through and there's like your special bionics commando team that's going in and trying to stop him. And over the course you learn about how the villain from the last game, Groder, is actually involved still, even though he shouldn't be alive. And
he's been killed in every Bionic Commando game,
yep,
by
yep.
the way.
He has been killed in every Bionic Commando game.
Yep.
And so pretty generic stopping him, but also as a part of this big mission, all of the Bionic Commandos either end up killed or missing in action, and there's some more stuff that goes into that later, but it leads into basically why in 2K9 that Spencer is considered a traitor and in prison and a bunch of stuff that makes no real sense.
Good. Glad I didn't miss much.
Yup.
All right, we've still got one more cycle if you want to put some,
sure.
some donations.
I've got $20 from Johan Lessard. Hey, what's up? Loving it as always. Keep it up. My donation is going to Super Metroid because I love Metroid. Keep it up. Keep it up to the million. Yes, guys. Thank you for already your well over 500, coming up on $600,000 you guys have already raised for Doctors Without Borders that you've helped us out with. We've still got about 48 hours left of some really amazing runs, including stuff like Boshi later, Mario 3, Mario Sunshine, stuff like that tonight. Super Metroid, Mario 64, Chrono Trigger, so many great runs. Make sure you get in your donations, and let's push towards the $1 million mark.
Actually, I'm going to go revisit some stages now, the ones that I needed to, the ones that I skipped items in earlier, because I now have the item that I need to open those. So if you want to read some stuff, I guess you can keep going.
Oh, yeah. we've got plenty, so
right.
Sure. All right. I've got $10 from Sinstacked. Some Insomniacs on the U.S. East Coast are still up, too. GDQ's created my love for OOT speedruns and Cosmo. My $10 goes to completing the Pokemon Puzzle League. Love what Doctors Without Borders stands for. Absolutely agree. I've also got $5 from Deadstock. Hey, SGDQ. Been watching for a few years now. Wanted to be a part of this one when it came around again, so here I am via donation. Hope the speedrunners continue to inspire people to help those in need for a long time to come. Cheers. Let's finish strong. $10 anonymously donated, saying special thanks to the people behind the scenes and who keep the cords plugged in. Absolutely. Amazing shout out, big old shout outs to our tech crew for really doing an amazing job this year.
Yeah, for sure. The tech has been a big step up from what it has been in the past.
Absolutely agreed. $30 from Vissen DPS. Always enjoy AGDQ and SGDQ. It's a ton of fun and for a great cause. I'm really excited to see Cave Story, one of my favorite games. Donation goes to Runner's Choice. Save the frames, kill the animals. Which I guess actually while we're here, PJ, did you have a Runner's Choice?
I'm going to kill the animals.
Oh, baby.
If they don't, I'm gonna.
$10 from Syl. I love watching these early morning, for you Americans, blanket streams. The people on the couch look so comfy. Greetings from Finland. Thank you for the amazing work you all do. $50 from our own Jape. Hey, Marathon. Love the games, especially Cave Story and this wonderful cause. Sad I couldn't be there this time around, but always next time. Go to Draculantern. Balos is no match for you. Please put this towards the speedrunner's choice. $87 from Louie. Here's enough to get us to 100% run on Bionic Commando 2 Rearmed. We have to give PJ as many opportunities as possible to get marathon luck. $50 donated anonymously. I wanted to wait until PJ's run to donate, but the incentives need to be met first. Good luck to all the runners, and I can't wait to see Pokemon blindfolded. $50 from Joachim Scheuberg. Two nights ago, my girlfriend and I were watching SGDQ when we realized we had to leave for the hospital as our son was ready to step into the world.
Oh, wow.
Everything went well, and we spent the following day recovering at the hospital while continuing to watch the fantastic work done by runners and staff at the event. All three of us sent a heartfelt thank you. Awesome. Congratulations to you guys. $20 from Graf. He says, here's a preemptive hashtag things PJ breaks. $50 from Giaka. Keep up the good work, guys. Awesome event this year. Good luck to all the runners. Also, speaking of things PJ breaks, a quick update on the bidding war.
I'm so excited to hear the total.
Yo, Silence has $80. Sick.
Wow, well done.
1,281, though, for hype.
Yes.
Yep. All right, closing in on the last revisit here. This one's pretty short. You might be noticing that I'm jumping a lot when I play this game, and the jump was actually one of the reasons I didn't want to play this game initially, because having played all of the other Bionic Commando games, Quiet, Spencer, you'll have your chance. having played all the others, I really liked the fact that you couldn't jump in this game. It made it like really unique. But jumping in this really helps make it more fluid. And
the level design is clearly based on the intention of you using the jump to add to your movement tools.
Yeah, for sure. The other reason is that you can't walk while holding diagonal.
He had to breathe.
So if I'm holding upright and I want to grapple diagonally, I can't. Like, I just stop moving once I press up. And every time you do that on every diagonal grapple, you lose time. And the jumps in this are completely committal. It's like Castlevania jump or Ghouls and Ghosts jump. So that is just like really handy for keeping my momentum forward while I grapple. It's a pretty necessary thing in a speedrun, and it definitely works in this game.
It's also just such a short jump that you can't really use it for platforming in any real way.
Right. All right, so the weapon that we got from the gorilla is the Euro Viper. That's the electric ball launcher. and it is probably the most overpowered weapon in the game, besides the suicide gun. Is he gonna shoot? Nope. All right. It's actually really important that he doesn't shoot during those swings. Fortunately, his gun only had one bullet, I guess, so we're good. Yeah, you're supposed to use the Yoru Viper there, too. Like, at this point, I have every weapon that I need to unlock things. I have the Hacking Claw, the Yoru Viper, a bazooka, grenades. But I still won't use them in most cases, because the game knows that you have them, so it starts designing puzzles, and I just don't do them.
Why do puzzles when you can just scream at things until they do what you want?
Exactly. It's just the stupidest. So, I guess some background on hype mode. I did it once by complete accident and just lost it. I was laughing like an idiot for like 20 minutes. You can maybe imagine why. But I couldn't get it to happen again. And there was someone on Twitter, I forget the name and I apologize. He had a video of him doing it, and it kind of helped me learn how to do it, but I still didn't really understand. And then during one practice run, I tried to do Death Room Above, like just past an elevator to break some blocks, and I cut it short, landed on the elevator, and just started screaming. And I was like, I think I can do something with this. Yeah, so I literally found the elevator set up, what, 2 days ago?
Yeah,
yeah,
sounds right.
That's accurate.
Yep.
Two or three at most.
That was a really good stage,
yeah,
by the way.
That
stage
good.
Can go really poorly. So can this one. So here we go. Choo-choo. Alright, so this first grapple, you're supposed to go all the way to the right and climb up a bit and then swing across these lanterns and come back over. But that first try is really impressive.
Wow.
There.
Nicely done.
Yeah, it's like literally one pixel. You can grab that if you're really lucky. So that saves a bunch of time. Oh, I didn't get it. Come on, Spencer. Really?
Gotta step it up.
Weren't you impressed by your grapple? Oh.
Oh.
There we go.
There we go.
There we are.
There we are. Most important trick of the level. Yeah. This is a really long level, too, so I hope... If you're voting for silence, you're gonna have to really do some legwork here. This is a scary part. Fortunately, no one shot bullets. Their guns weren't loaded. Okay. Actually, I stopped screaming, didn't I?
Yeah, the boss.
Yep.
Yeah.
Cutscene.
He was intimidated by the boss. I don't know what else to say.
Say that.
I know what to say.
those are good words.
Yep.
So to the right here is this gas puzzle, and you're supposed to hit these switches, and eventually it'll take you down here. But so does the elevator. The gas puzzle is really cool, but it's a shame it's a lot slower than just going directly through the floor. I also have to grab this before I forget.
This is a prime example of why when PJ tells us he found a new game he wants to play, we instantly fear for its safety.
Yep. There's no remorse, but a lot of fear.
Yeah, this stage is really, really cool. It's like a construction zone or something. So there's just a bunch of like really separated platforms, and if you miss a grapple, you're usually in big trouble. What was I didn't fire that.
Spencer disagrees.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's probably our first example of an enemy bonking me. And it's a really big problem in this game. Sometimes you just get insane momentum when you touch an enemy, and it's like completely random. So you'll like try and pull yourself through a floor and just get like launched 40 tiles to the right. And oh well. This is an amusement park for him. I'm out of Eurowiper. Really?
You having trouble?
Maybe this will hit?
Okay. It sure did.
Yeah, weapons in this game just sometimes choose to not do the things that they're supposed to do. Alright. That was an okay level.
So I've probably read literally thousands of donations for the GDQs at this point. This is probably one of my five favorite I've ever read.
Oh, boy.
I've got $20 from K-Man. For years, I thought that Navi's listen was the most headache-inducing sound in video games. And then I met Spencer and his uncontrollable rage hype. Normally, I would donate for silence, but this run is all about poor life choices.
And there is evidence, right?
Yep. And the kids at the community library I work at don't want the hype to end.
Oh. Those kids are never going to be the same.
Nope.
So you might have noticed in the beginning I didn't go the right way to get that item. You're supposed to just wrap around to the right and blow open the door. But again, you can just use the back door, go through the floor, excuse me? Okay. And climb underneath the mountain and get it, and it's a little bit faster. This is actually a really neat level. There's a really wonky clip coming up that I hope you enjoy.
Okay.
Body slam. All right, so there's a barrel, which means I'm going through it. Again, here you're supposed to fire the Euroviper and turn the gas off. I'm just gonna go right through the ceiling.
That looks fine.
All right, Terminator, hold your breath. Hold your breath.
Huh.
There's a ton of lag there, and the game really concerns me whenever that happens. One of these days, it's gonna bite the big one and just be done. Okay, cool.
I've got $30 from the button mashers. With this much yelling in Bionic Commando, my bosses can't tell if I'm watching Dragon Ball Z or not. Why are you watching this at work? Let's hope that we don't have as much filler. Donation goes towards the Chrono Trigger 100% run because reasons.
Yeah, Chrono Trigger 100% is a pretty great run. It's a good reason.
Yeah, let's actually check a quick update on that. We've still got a bunch of things you guys can donate for. Let's see actually a couple coming up real quick while PJ's moving through the game.
This boss is the only... Oh, that's not true. There are two unique bosses in this game. This is the only time we fight him, and it's a really short battle, and it's pretty cool, honestly. You shoot this guy in here, and this is actually the one cutscene I did watch. The cutscene before this boss, and like, Spencer doesn't know who this guy is, and he doesn't know who I am, and we just yell at each other. And, like, he calls me Randall, and I don't... yeah, the conversation doesn't make any sense, and then we fight. And, yeah, I basically just hit him a whole bunch. He tries to plant the anti-aircraft gun here. I unplant it, and then he shoots himself off the stage. So, his health isn't gone yet. yeah. I guess we can clap for that, sure. You can jump off the stage and start, like, screaming and fall to your death. And then, like, you die as he dies, and the game's like, game over, level complete. And weird things happen, but I didn't want to risk it and then have to refight the whole boss again. So this is a stage in which you're supposed to actually get the bazooka. But I've had it for a long time, so I'm well acquainted. This level is called Descent, which, as you could guess, means we're just going to go back down the mountain. And Spencer is really good at going through things. So this stage happens. So up there, I broke the wall, and I activated a checkpoint. Now I'm going to kill myself and go all the way back up the mountain. This is going to be home base for a bit. At the very beginning of this stage, there's an item above the mountaintop. And you normally have to go to the end of the stage. Oh, wow. Second try is really good.
That's really good.
Wow. You normally have to go to the end of the stage and then climb up this whole thing all the way back to the beginning. But I can take the shortcut if I do a really precise clip. And it's actually the same clip that I did in stage 2, if you remember that one. Except I don't have to do it completely blind this time. I can actually see what's going on. So I die once more to get back to here, and now we actually go through the rest of the stage. Even when the screaming doesn't continue, you just know what can happen. Yeah, so at this point, I would go all the way back and get the item from the beginning. So it's a pretty big detour. I actually don't know how you're supposed to do this puzzle. come on, Rockets, please. There you go. Yeah, so I... Uh-oh. Deserved. This game's really generous with checkpoints, though. And in every level, one of the power-ups is checkpoint... Or, is checkpoint. It's a good power-up. One of the power-ups is a one-up. And it adds to your total number of lives upon entering a stage.
So yeah, if you have 12 lives, then you start every stage with 12 lives, not a continued count.
Nice.
Wow, I don't remember the last time I've seen you not get bonked there.
Yep. Oh, we almost got machine gun glitch too. He's really trying to talk to this guy, but his communication skills are not good.
Are you okay?
If he wasn't dead before, he is now.
How's it feel knowing you're going to get endless complaints from parents who now, every time their child gets on an elevator, is literally going to scream for the rest of the day?
I'm fine with it. I'm more concerned about what my Twitter is going to look like. Or what chat looks like right now. All right, good. He screamed too hard.
Killed those spikes,
boss. I'm actually surprised those killed me in one hit, because that's not something that can usually happen. I got bonked. Help. Robot Factory is one of my favorite stages. This is a really, really cool stage. Yeah, we get all these cool conveyor belts and a bunch of switches and stuff. All the enemies are robots, which is pretty neat and makes sense. And we get our first encounter with this guy, the weird bubble thing that bonks you and then goes, what? And then blows up. And it doesn't do any damage, it just bonks you and makes you really annoyed because your grapple line just broke. So I actually want to go back down there by the bonk droid. Ordinarily, you would have to turn off these gas jets, but sometimes you can get through without dying, and they're supposed to be instant kill. And I don't know how it works, I just know what I have to do to get it to not work, and then that's what I do.
Invisible this barrel?
Is, yeah, this is... It's convenient, right? A completely empty room, except the one thing I need.
PJ in a nutshell. I don't know how it works, but I know how to get it to not work.
So this is actually supposed to be a completely different room, but instead of having the room in a different room, it's just one big room, and unfortunately for them, it's beneath the first one. So, come on, you. We had a good stage, aren't you happy? No, I guess he's not. All right.
He was pensive, but...
Question mark.
I've got $5 donated anonymously. I hereby dub your setup the Yellevator.
I approve.
Yep.
I approve. All right, so this next stage is the encore presentation of Gorilla Boss, in case you missed it before. And it's like 2 minutes longer. I don't know who designed this, but I wish they hadn't. So the main difference with this guy is that he has one extra complete cycle and one extra attack per cycle. So he does the same sweeping hand thing every time. It's a bit faster, but still, once you know how it works, it's just pretty trivial. And every time he sweeps his hands across, he does the Chef Master attack. But now he does it twice. Or he sweeps the other way. So, yeah. This boss is also interesting. That's the bad word. This boss has some quirks about him that if you try and play around too much during this boss fight, there's a good chance that you either hardlock your console, softlock the game, or make the boss unkillable. And this is the only stage in the entire game in which I've actually hardlocked the console. Alright, so there's the first phase. You break his ear off, and then I have the three phases actually damage him afterwards. But, like, his knuckles here, you can see I can't grab them. There's one specific point in this cycle when you can grab his knuckle, and if you're unfortunate enough to pull, the game thinks you grabbed his ear instead, and it pulls his ear off. But the ear is the thing that you actually have to pull off to make him vulnerable, and the game just gets really confused and doesn't let you do it ever again. So you can go up there and you grab the ear and you'll pull it like a little bit and then that's it and you're just stuck. So yeah, I really can't do anything interesting here. There's also a chance that you just fall through the floor in this stage. So I'm just gonna hope that things don't happen, and I'm gonna go ahead and toss it over to Spike Vegeta.
Absolutely. So to just remind you guys of a couple of incentives that still need to be met that are going on here in just a few hours after this run. Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion will have a any percent, however, no out of bounds category done by Bubbles Del Fuego. However, if you guys donate another, let's see, we're sitting right now at about $3,100 out of $7,500, then he'll also be doing an any percent category of Oblivion. So if you need more Oblivion in your life, you need to get those donations in. Still need about another $4,400 for that. Also, for Dust Force DX, there is a play a super hard secret level incentive. because the game just isn't hard enough already. That's still going to need another about 2,300. It's sitting at 2,671 at a 5K right now. So if you guys want to see those, make sure you get your donations in soon, because they'll be happening here just in the next few hours.
What's that Yorl Piper doing?
Circling.
I'm concerned. Okay, it went away.
Yeah, Yorl Viper, he tries his hardest.
I've also got $25 from the Corey. I missed the Kingdom Hearts run this year because it was very early, but if I can hear Spike Vegeta give his best Kingdom Hearts is Light again, I'll surely donate again. Also, kill the animals. Kingdom Hearts is Light! I hope I sounded enough like a pubescent boy there, all right? I've got $5 from Camphor Wolf. I've never seen a man so enthusiastic about elevators. And $30 donated anonymously. PJ sure knows how to entertain. Money goes towards announcer's choice since his laugh made my day.
All right, so we killed that guy, and he was gracious enough to give us the suicide gun. The game calls it the Napalm Launcher, but that's the wrong name.
It is.
There was a mistranslation.
Yep, mistranslation. So yeah, when you fire this gun, there's a good chance that you're just dead. I'll show it off here, and the helicopter is probably going to explode. I've actually never fired it here before. Okay, that was harmless. Yeah, you shoot it, and it just creates a gigantic ball of fire that instantly kills you if even the smoke touches you. I don't really know what you're supposed to use it for, but I use it to kill myself, because checkpoints are a thing in this game. And I also use it for one boss fight, but that's about it. Yeah, this stage is pretty much the exact same as the other helicopter stage, except there are these rocket launcher guys that fall through the floor when you kill them. And, yeah.
And you're not screaming at everything
and
while
I'm not
destroying them.
Right, I'm not screaming at everything. Well, most of the enemies here are robots. They can't be intimidated by my screaming. Also, there is no elevator.
Either or.
Yeah. Yeah, so we've got, I don't know, maybe 30 seconds to squeeze in a few more donations if you want.
I've got $200 from Doug Snyder. Silence is golden. Let the horse rest in peace. You're going to need a lot more than that, buddy. But thank you for your $200 of generosity.
Wow, yeah.
$50 from Joseph82. Thanks, PJ. Now I have Spencer's scream stuck in my head.
Yeah, me too.
I'll hear that phantom howl for the rest of the day. Thanks a lot. Put this towards Chrono Trigger 100%. And yeah, just to give a quick update on the Chrono Trigger 100% run, we're getting there. You guys have already raised $44,477.25 for that 100% incentive alone. Still need to get to $65,000 total for it in order to actually see the 100% run. So make sure you keep getting in your donations, guys. Still got about 48 hours left of event, and there's still a lot of stuff we need to meet.
Good targeting.
Yeah, thanks.
Showing those rocks, you boss.
All right, so the auto-scroller is over, and now we get the pleasure of playing my least favorite stage. This stage is... it's really bad if you want to go quick, because the optimal way to grapple is extremely risky, and if you miss it, like if you miss a grapple, then you lose like 40 seconds. So I have to take this really, really slow. This is the switch room down here. I need to open up this gate to get the Yashiji, and to do so. It's still pulling the switch, actually. The sound effect was still playing, so this will be interesting. All you have to do is hit 4 switches, and it doesn't even matter if you hit them all in one life or if you die and redo it. All you have to do is hit 4, and they don't even have to be unique switches. Like, if you really like one switch, you can just hit it four times. Unlock it, go die, and then do it again. And the game's perfectly fine with that. All right. Okay. Guess we get to do it again. Surprise. Oh my gosh, please. Please just get me out of this stage. Everything's gonna be okay, Spencer. We'll find you an elevator. Alright. I should be okay now. Interesting. Hmm. Did the enemy hit me, or?
I don't
we'll
think.
Just say that.
Or question mark.
Don't worry about that.
All right, and again here I can swing all the way over, but if you don't have a really really long grapple, you miss it, and then you have to go a pretty far ways. What? That attack kills that enemy.
Yeah. It does.
All right.
You're not hype enough to kill him.
I know. I'll try falling from further. Yeah, I honestly have no idea why that did not kill that enemy, because it's 100% guaranteed. Or, oh, I guess 98% guaranteed now. Might be trapped. Good design. Oh, gosh. We'll get through it, Spencer. Everything's gonna be fine. For a few stages. Come on. I'm just gonna really, really overshoot this now. Or I'm not. Okay. No, no, no. No, no, no. This way. All right, we did it. Huzzah! Oh gosh. Yeah, the stage proceeded as normal. Clap, yeah.
Yep. Beat minor enemy.
Yeah. Alright, well the stage is done. We'll do the action hero pose at the end. Level 1 action hero pose. And then we're stuck in this cardboard, this wooden box. And I have a grenade launcher, a rocket launcher, napalm gun, and a bionic arm, and I cannot get out of this. So,
yep, completely trapped.
Yeah. So they put me in prison, and they weren't smart enough to just completely pull my arm off when they put me in prison, like they were in 2K9. So, yeah, they put me in basically a jungle gym with a bionic arm, and Spencer's like, all right, this is kind of fun. We could do this.
Who designed this place?
Well, not only did they not take your arm, they didn't take any of your weapon either.
Well, they were scared of the suicide gun. If they took it, they might accidentally use it. Nice. I'm actually really glad I grabbed that, because that's a scary grab. And one more? Alright, we're good now.
Yeah, these tight corridors make for some awkward swings and grapples.
Yeah, especially because you can wall jump. So if you're pushing any direction, you instantly stick to the wall and you can't grapple. So you have to make sure that when you get into that narrow corridor, you just stop pushing buttons. Run! Question? I like when the enemies. Okay. I took him.
He was trying to protect the barrel.
Yeah, I took him with me. Through the floor. All right, so we got an upgrade for the suicide gun. This is where it starts to get really powerful. Alright. There's a property for this shotgun that I didn't mention. It can fire through walls, which is really good. Well, through gates if you're close enough. Well, actually walls too if you're close enough. I use it to hit some switches early. Very early in the run. Let's see if I can get dancing mode. Yep, that'll do it. So this guy died during the cutscene, and now he just can't stop grooving. And he's dead, but...
It's a shame we couldn't cheer him on.
I know, yeah. Don't worry, we can cheer on the others. All right. Action hero exit!
Man, the crickets know he's not screaming.
Yeah. So we escaped from prison, we just ran into the jungle. After I fired a napalm. Probably wasn't the best play. And somehow after that, we end up in the Bionic Labs. This is probably my favorite stage in the game. This is a really, really cool stage if you play it legitimately. And if you play it not legitimately, it's still a really cool stage. Stand up, see what happens. Oh, that jerk.
Wow.
Really? Got him.
Couldn't let him see the setup.
Yep, yeah.
He might try it himself.
So you're supposed to hit a lot of switches to get down here and open up these gates, but again, barrels are better than switches in this game. It's gonna be okay, I promise. Come on. Alright. Unfortunately, I have to kill the hype here. Because I have to smash that thing. The crushers, I don't know if I mentioned them or not, but if you're moving at all, if your grapple line is attached to anything and you're near a crusher, you instantly die, and the game makes it really embarrassing for you, and it flings you 20 screen lengths away, or sometimes directly into the camera or other question mark. I'll leave my grapple there, I guess. This door should still be open, though. It wasn't close enough, I guess.
It's a shame you only have, 19 more lives to work with?
Yep. Alright, so the death there actually was intentional that time. Incoming worst noise. You might think you knew it, but nope. You were wrong.
What is that?
That's the sound of computers being hacked. So if your computer starts making that noise, first of all, you did something really wrong. And then you should just...
unplug it.
Yeah. Spencer don't care. Nice. Landed directly on it. Alright, so, up next is the only not-cycle-based boss in this game. And if you fight him, in the any percent category, without all the upgrades, it's a really long fight, and he has attacks I don't even know how to dodge. I don't even know if he can. But I don't bother. Don't bother dodging, because I kill him before that anyways. And in 100%, it's just basically me mashing buttons a whole lot.
Yeah, each of the guns are on their own kind of timer, so by rotating through them, get a lot of shots out.
All right. So now he goes on the ceiling, he electrifies the floor and fires these rockets at you. I can just break all the rockets before they get to me. And I can kind of whittle away his health with the Yoro Viper as we wait. And if I did enough damage in the first round, I should be able to kill him shortly after he lands. But we will see. Nope, I did not. But we still won with the magic pixel of health.
Good enough.
Mm-hmm.
So at this point, Gorilla is back again. I don't have to fight him. That guy that I just killed orders the Gorilla to kill the Bionic, and Gorilla's like, well, wait, you've got more Bionic parts than he does, and just grabs him. And he has two arms, but he only wants the one guy, so I just leave.
So I already learned that we'll just keep poking him in the ear if he tries to mess with us.
So the reactor, the first time you play this game, is extremely difficult. And it's still a really difficult stage, but knowing where everything is and where things are crumbling helps a lot. The gimmick of this stage is that the whole thing is collapsing and flooding. So the water level steadily rises, and some platforms that you might want to ride just break. But the parts that break are the same every time, so as long as you know, then you can avoid standing on them. In any percent, it's pretty easy to get to the top before the water drowns you, but in 100%, you really have to book it, because the items that you have to get kind of snake all around the level. But I haven't drowned in a long time. Hopefully this won't be the first. Okay. Alright, that's a really tough one. That should be the last dangerous part of this stage. You can grab this Yashichi as you fall, but sometimes the grapple doesn't work the way you want it to. So I actually land inside and grab it. I have enough time to do that without worrying about drowning. Okay, and the exit is right up here.
Uh-oh.
Suicide gun. Too tempting.
Showboating too hard.
All right, well, fortunately, we're not far away from the exit. If you take the direct path. I'm not going to equip suicide gun. All right. We did it.
You didn't drown.
I didn't
Congratulations.
Drown.
Congratulations.
I didn't drown, but I blew up. I caught on fire. Probably should have jumped in the water.
I've got $100 from Patty95. Hello, world. Patty here from Comics and Beer. Shoutouts to all the staff for always putting on such an amazing event. I was so busy with work and impending first child, I almost missed SGDQ. I'll be spreading the word, yeah, sure, extra hard for AGDQ. I love showing the world that gamers will give us an entire week of their lives to help some amazing causes. You runners are true heroes. Super split here on my $100. Keep up the hype. Races are fun to watch. 100% chrono is a must. Kill the animals. $30 to announcer's choice and $30 to power up audio's choice for doing such an amazing job. Goodbye, world.
Goodbye, world. All right, so this is the general HQ. This is one of the coolest stages in the game. I do it almost completely backwards. Those two switches that I hit, you have to go through like the whole stage to go get to them. But again, there's a barrel. So I just go open them up and I can grab the item that they unlock, which helps a lot. This guy better not get in my way. What? No, you come back. I'm not done with you.
There we go.
Yeah, so this level is absolutely gigantic. And the things that I need to collect are scattered to the corners of the world. Spencer is ready, though. I really hope I get this. If you're fast enough, you can climb all the way to the top here before these guys start shooting at you. Nice.
Nice climb.
Yeah, that is really, really hard.
Yeah, and doing it if you don't get it the first time takes like three times as long.
What? That guy literally blew up the barrel to stop me from getting out of bounds. I have never seen him even shoot at a barrel before. That guy's had enough of me. I think I probably blew my cover with the screaming.
Yeah.
They're like, this, something's not right about this guy. Probably shouldn't let him go down here.
There are no words.
No.
Nope. All right. Suicide gun time. Excuse me? Suicide gun time. On fire and scream. I kind of feel bad for him now. All right. So we got most of the stuff that we need. There's just a few more items. Bonk. The guy, oh, he broke my grapple. That's what happened. Okay. All right. Wait, what? What was flying around there?
Don't worry about that.
I'm a little worried about it. Nice. Uh-oh. Okay. Nice. Those are really tricky grapples. Okay. So if you don't kill yourself there and have a checkpoint up here, you have to go down and go through, like, the whole stage again. So that suicide saves a ton of time. Grappling off missiles, no big deal. So this is the trap here, because there's a cutscene, so you think it's the end of the stage, and I usually fire the suicide gun there and then die.
Only you could make that an obstacle in your own run.
Yep.
Killed myself too soon. Whoops. Alright, the next stage is Countdown, I think. Yeah, so this stage baffled me for a really long time, and I think I kind of figured it out now. The obstacles are just ingeniously placed in this stage. Nice.
Nice grab.
Excuse me. All right, good. No, no. So if I touch this water at all, if any part of me touches the water, I instantly die.
Spencer is impressively bad at swimming.
Yeah. Nice. I'm really glad I grabbed that, because I would have died if I hadn't. Oh. Actually, I should be able to just go this way. Yeah. All right, now we're at a checkpoint. So I'm going to let this guy kill me, because I need... Like, you literally need... close to full health to get the next item.
right.
Yeah, so the only way to get this item is to literally smash your body against the spikes and then grab it. And when I first did it, like, that was the first thing that came to mind for me. It was like, well, I can't get across there. Time to throw myself onto the spikes. And that's actually the way you have to do it.
Wow.
Missed the last grapple. I wonder if my checkpoint is still there. Or if it reset it. Nice. Yeah, this last part is really, really scary because every enemy can anti-air you here. But we did it! The guy just randomly falls towards the camera at the end of the stage. As you can maybe guess by the golf cart icon on the map, we have to refight the golf cart boss. Sorry, the helicopter. He's pretty much identical, except he fires rockets now once in a while. And I don't have the safe spot at the side, so I do have to swing and grab these things and fight him the way that you're supposed to do it. So every time he attacks, only two of the thrusters ignite. Somehow he's still able to hover and not just spiral out of control during this. But yeah, you shoot in the middle, you break the side ones, and then you just wait.
Also, doesn't actually have anything that would make it a helicopter.
Sure it does. It's just got, a thing up there.
Engines?
Engines. If I fall down too soon, sometimes the game lags a whole bunch, and I'm really concerned about the game crashing. So I'm also just going to crouch and dodge the missiles instead.
Yeah, the missile sound is just as horrifying as it was there.
Yeah. Yeah, it gets worse if you get hit by them. Like, the whole screen just, like, freezes for a few seconds. Yes, this might be our last opportunity for donations, if you want to read some.
Absolutely, and I want to once again just plug real quick that coming up after this, Rome, we only got just a few minutes left in it. We got Fallout, Fallout 3, and Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion. And if you guys want, at the end of that block, we will be getting an any percent run of Oblivion. If you guys donate another, let's say, about $4,000. We're about 34.39 out of 7,500. So if you want to see that, get in your donations as soon as you can. For donations themselves, I've got $50 from Booger Ghost. Good name. I scream, you scream, we all scream for PJ. Another hilarious and amazing speedrun from PJ. Looking forward to making Chrono Trigger 100% happen. $20 from Diaho. Really glad to be donating to Screaming Games Done Questionably. Keep up the great work, everyone. $50 donated from Keel. I'm surprised that we got that far that people clap when PJ doesn't break a game.
I'm out of ammo somehow. So at the end of this stage, the missile pops up and then you walk through the door to get on the missile. But for some reason, the game lets you do it early and Spencer just goes. So I already walked into the background. Here's the missile I'm supposed to get on, and then the door appears after that. So he just doesn't care. He's ready.
One last donation I'll try to fit in here. Yep. $30 from Nick R.P. Green. Introduced my girlfriend to SGDQ this year after watching a few myself already. She has been really enjoying it up until, why does he keep screaming? Put my donation towards the Oblivion any percent, because there's always room for more glitchy Havoc engine plays.
I didn't grab my own face there. That is
very
lucky.
Nice.
Wow. Yeah, in two of my practice runs this week, I tried to make that grapple and Spencer grabbed his face. Like, I can't really explain it any more than that. It happened and I lost a lot of health and also laughed for a long time. Let's get this. So this is a missile level. This stage is really, really neat, and I'm glad that the right music is playing on it, because when I practiced, it had the wrong music. So the gimmick here is that you have to go into all of these missiles and break their reactors. And then the missile crumbles, and we have to jump to the next one. Nice. I'm actually really glad I got that. Wow, that is a gigantic skip.
Yeah.
Wow.
So yeah, we broke the first missile. There are, I believe, four, five? I don't know. We'll see. We'll find out.
Yeah, this level is just as scary the first time you play it as it looks like when you're playing it in a speedrun.
Yeah, this stage is terrifying. It's really cool. Like, I love the design, but it's mean. It's really mean. That Goliath launcher upgrade that I got, I thought was actually impossible to get with the speed booster equipped, because you move so fast that you only have a few frames to collect it, or to do the up grab before the spikes instantly kill you. Yeah, the grapples in this stage are so good. This is a scary room because there's crushers. And again, if my grapple is active when the crushers are moving at all, I instantly die. So I have to play it a bit careful there. Nice. That was a really good room.
Real curious how high into space we would have made it by now.
Yeah. So this is the escort mission of the stage. I have to bring the Euro Viper ball all the way through. Okay. That actually is the last missile. All right, so at this point, I've gotten everything in the game. That's what that last notification was. And that stage got clobbered.
Yeah,
that was
really
good.
Was really good.
It's 343. Oh my god.
Yeah, that was.
That might be actually my IL PB for that stage. Okay, so this is the final boss. Apparently this guy that I'm about to kill deactivated that last missile, I think. Doesn't really matter though, it's just another guy and I have to destroy him, because I am Spencer.
Yep. Yeah, this is like the only dynamic thing they did in the story, really, because the guy we're gonna fight is actually the helicopter pilot that's on our side. And
he's just tired of us screaming when he was trying to fly around.
But throughout the game, basically, as the mission's gotten more and more derailed, he's been trying to like follow us and follow through on his mission orders, but no one else is, and he can't figure out why, and he gets really, really mad about that. And then he also gets injured and steals all the bionic parts from all the other commandos who are on the team who died. And it turns out that's a really bad idea, and it makes him go completely crazy.
But not as crazy as Spencer. So what I have to do here is trigger this cutscene, and then just peace out. Because I have one last thing to do.
Oh, no.
Now I'm ready. So Spencer is really mad that this guy's trying to kill us. I was just climbing missiles, deactivating them with my hands, and this guy is here. I can equip this healing item just to make things safer, because sometimes you get set up in unblockable ways on this boss. Yep.
It's too early for this, PJ.
It's too early to feel sick. Those missiles just stopped circling and just hit me instead. I think they hurt. Alright, so the gimmick here is that you have to pick up this bomb ball thing and roll it. And it's the only time in the entire game you have to roll an object. And I didn't even know that you could do this when I got to this boss
yep.
the first time.
It's also the first time in the game they use the 3D to do any perspective
yep.
tricks.
Yep.
So just yeah. multiple really weird gimmicks that were never used anywhere in the game that are required to fight this boss.
Yeah. Yeah, I was not happy about this boss when I fought him the first time.
I knew you wouldn't be.
It's like, this is the stupidest thing. In hindsight, it's a neat boss, but not to play. Spencer knows, so he's so ready. I hope we don't get like a surprise 1,000 donation to turn it off.
It's too late now.
It's too late.
Oops.
All right, one more cycle. I just love, he's just casually crouching on the ground, just screaming as loud as he can.
He's got a pretty good set of lungs, too.
Yeah. Yeah. I really want to shoot the suicide gun. I know it's going to kill me. Come on, hold it together, Terminator. Hold it together.
This leg.
I know. So, now Spencer. Damn, rookies. Oh, I guess that's time, too. I'm sorry. New difficulty unlocked. Screaming mode. Unfortunately, it doesn't persist through the credits. I really wish it did, but it doesn't. So, he screams a bit into the loading zone. And then goes home. So yeah, that's BCR 2. Hope you all enjoyed the run.
Oh, we did.
Up next, we've got a pretty substantial PC block, beginning with mm-hmm. Fallout.
Yep,
right?
Fallout
3.
Fallout 3, and Oblivion.
Yeah.
So get hyped, guys. Once again, big thanks to PJ. Spencer, in particular.
Yeah, Spencer is the real hero here.
For donating his lungs to Doctors Without Borders.
Yep. Yep, thanks for having me. Thanks for all the donations to make this happen. Keep it up. We've got a few really good days of runs ahead of us.
I'll go ahead and power through some donations here as we start to get set up for the...